Now, on screen, you'll see I have a document set up with standard placeholder text. It's 3 pages long and basically each page is identical. Now what I want to do here is I want to add a watermark which will sit on the page behind the text and will make it clear to people either that I'm the owner of the document or that perhaps it is draft or it's private and confidential. Okay, so to do that, what we want to do is we want to go up to the design tab. So the fourth tab along, we've got design. And within design tab at the very end, at the right hand side, you'll see this group here and we have watermark. Now I'm going to click on watermark and you'll see there's two different options. So we're going to look at both of these just now. We've got picture and we've got text. Of course, the default is no watermark because any document you create in Microsoft Word by default will not have a watermark applied. But anyway, let's apply a picture as the watermark. So I'm going to select picture. And then what it will ask me to do is to select the picture from my computer. So I'm going to go into select picture and you'll see here in my downloads folder, I've got the logo for my golf blog. So you'll see Andy's golf blog. We've just got the standard image of a logo. Now you don't need to worry about your logo being transparent or your image being a certain type. Basically, just as long as it's an image file, you'll be able to bring this in. So here we have this JPEG of Andy's golf blog logo. I'm going to click insert and you'll see we then get asked about the scale. Now the scale here is already set to auto and we get a preview. So we can see because the logo is quite small, it's not really all that visible there. It sits in the center of the screen. But what I want to do is I want to change its size. So I'm going to change it to 100%. And then you'll see it now takes up much more of the page. It's far more visible. If that's too much, I'll maybe drop it down to 50. And that's probably what I'm looking for. Now you'll see where it says wash out. You'll see if you uncheck that, it makes it a lot more prominent. But the problem here is it's more difficult to read the text. So I'm going to leave it as wash out. Now all I do is click OK. And you'll see the logo will now appear on the page behind the text as a watermark. And it appears on each page of the document. If you create a new page, the watermark will also appear on that new page. The other option you have is to go back into the watermark menu, and then you will see instead of using picture, you can use text. So if I change it to text, you will see in the preview, we have this ASAP text. Now it's given me that by default, but what I can do is I can click on this more option and I can choose one of these from here. So we could have confidential. So there you go, confidential is sitting across here. We could have copy. And a common one that we see quite often is draft. Now you'll see these are all basically just horizontal. You can use the options below to customize your particular watermark if it is a piece of text. So for example, we can change the font. So I'm happy with that font there. Maybe size-wise, if I want it to be bigger, I could choose maybe 120, you'll see it's actually a little bit smaller. So I could manually input 200 and you'll see it will be much bigger. We can also make it bold and italics if we want. The other thing we can do is we can choose whether or not it's horizontal or diagonal. Now if I choose diagonal, you'll see it's much better and in my opinion, much clearer sitting like that. The final thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the font color. And in this one, I'll make it maybe like a dark blue so it's a lot more obvious. Now in this case, this works okay. If the transparency needs to be increased, then you can increase it and you'll see it's now a little bit easier to read the text with the blue. Whereas before on the gray color, the transparency being set to 0 was probably okay. So if I'm happy with this, I'll click okay. And then you'll see it has added it to the document. So every page of this document now has that watermark. When you go to print, it will print the watermark on the document. So if I go to file and print, we'll get a preview just in here, but you can see that's how it looks. And just remember, it will appear a lot darker, okay? So it's quite transparent for you to work on the document, but when you print this, it will be quite dark and visible, okay? So if I click print, it will print out, of course. Now, the final thing is if I want to remove the watermark, all I do is go back into the watermark menu. And instead of choosing text or picture, all you do is choose no watermark and click OK. And then you'll see it has removed the watermark from the document. Again, if I now go up to print, you will see that there is no watermark displayed on any page of this particular document.